In this house, I started to work first with the organization, the opening, the windows. For example, this opening on my back has been done. And I love the back of the other house, and it's really, really working. There is a room upstairs where you have wallpaper, raffia, and leather. I bring layers of ornamentation in the house, and I'm not using painting or sculpture. I work with the artisan, like for example, you are talking about leather, and this leather is done in a very old shop in Paris. I'm talking a lot about invisible space, like for example, cupboard, where you put your clothes in. I tried in my room to work the cupboard as a piece of furniture I love to have in my room. We call that in France cabinet de curiosité. So that's, for example, an invisible space. In this house, you have a toilet and you have an oculus looking to the wine cellar. For me, I think it's important that the toilet is having also a category of a space to be used. In this house, there was a pool. It was more kitschy, pinky, small swimming pool. So I started from there and I found these big pieces of green marble. It's a room that we use as a swimming pool, but it's also a room where you can go down and talk, and I have also some drinks there. I tried to experiment some colored windows, and I realized that finally it's bringing more light to have a blue, an orange, a green, than to have only transparent. I'm not an interior decorator, I'm an interior architect. I think I'm mainly modernist. The period of the Bauhaus, where you were doing architecture, but craft and art were also very important. So that would be, let's say, more my style.